So let's start again by looking at where 10 and 16 fall in the distribution. 10 is 3 points less than the mean, and 16 is 3 points greater than the mean. So if this is the mean, 13, this is 10, and here's 16, we're looking for the area in between those two. How might we figure this out? Well, what we'll do is we'll find the area under 16, and then we'll subtract the area less than 10. So what's the area less than 16? First, let's convert 16 to a z-score. 16 minus 13 divided by 4.8. So this is 0.625. Since 10 is equidistant from 13 as 16 is, then the z-score for 10 is going to be negative 0.625. You can go ahead and calculate that if you want. Sometimes that helps things make more sense. So let's find the area less than a z-score of 0.625. We'll find 0.6 in the vertical column, and we'll have to round to the hundredths place since that's as detailed as the z-table gets. So we'll round to 0.63. So that's this column, and we should get 0.7357. And then we'll subtract the area less than 10, which has a z-score of negative 0.625. So here's negative 0.6, and here's the column for 0.03. So the area less than negative 0.63 is 0.2643. Notice that since these are the same values, just one's positive and one's negative, then the area less than 0.625 plus the area less than 0.625 adds to 1. So basically this area here plus this area here equals 1. That's because the area here is equal to the area here. So if you add 0.7357 and 0.2643, you should get 1. So that's just a property of the symmetry of the normal distribution. So if we subtract them, we get 0.4714. And that's the area here in between 10 and 16.